Ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and this video probably should have gone up yesterday, but there were things, and then there were some reasons, and then there was some insomnia and the like that I don't think would really interest people all that much, so instead, let's focus on why we're all here. Good old Electronic Arts has managed to step into it with both feet yet again. It's starting to seem like it's very much a when it rains it pours scenario when it comes to AAA fuckery being afoot these days, but this particular issue highlights in a very spectacular fashion the potential pitfalls that arises from digital distribution and all of the games that you think you own. You find out that is not entirely the case. But before I start ripping into EA for my own pound of flesh here, let's go through just the facts, something that a lot of you have been commenting on that you actually like my clearly separating the basic rundown from my own opinion. Even many of you that stay and listen to what I have to say think it's a really good idea. So as you all tend to like my disassociation between the two, I figure it might be a format we'll stick to a little more closely moving forward when discussing topics such as these. And as always, you can find links to all the sources used along with the links to my social media and Patreon in the description down below. So what are the facts? Well, let's start off with the core issue, and then we'll cover the developments as they happened throughout the day yesterday. We have the origin user Flying Officer, who served a decade in the Indian Air Force, hence the use of that particular handle, who went to log into his origin account 2 weeks ago and found himself unable to do so. When Flying Officer reached out to EA support, they stated that there was no trace of his user ID. He went through the process of providing them with transaction IDs, order IDs, and game keys, which normally should be more than enough to locate an account, but EA stated that they had no information at all on any of it. It would also appear that in the initial conversation, EA provided very vague explanations as to what might be going on. And when you go and search for the profile, you can still find it. However, it would appear the account has either been marked private or has in fact had some portion of it deleted. Also, when one goes to inspect the source, you can still find the nucleus ID of the account, which means the web-based account is still present in some form. And then again, that also doesn't mean much if it's a web portal ID that is only used as a pointer to an account on a back-end system, which would be very likely in this case. So it would appear that somehow this person just had his account up and deleted by EA with no notification, no confirmation email, no nothing, just gone. A Flying Officer then posted an update, which was a copy-paste of the live chat conversation with an Origin help desk technician that was extremely unhelpful, which is no real surprise there. If you're dealing with a tier 1 tech and they can't even call up an account ID, they're really not going to be of much help. He then posted another update showing that his case ID for this situation had also been deleted by EA. Then there was another update where he was still apparently working with EA support and had provided his credit card information to them again, most likely in the hopes that they would be able to pull up something using that. Then the most recent update was that Sarah from EA told him that they were unable to get any details related to his account in any way, and she had asked him to create a new one where they would add back his games onto that new account. And indeed, when we go to his new profile, it appears that they are working on getting his games re-added to his new account, of course lacking any and all achievements and any microtransaction purchases. And there we have it. Also, I know that some of you were probably thinking, oh, it was probably a hacker that got into his account, which, speaking from personal experience, having my own Steam account and Origin accounts compromised in the past, these hackers don't delete accounts. They don't delete anything. They take them over and either make use of them or sell them on the gray market. It's simply not worth the effort to hack into an account just to delete it. The primary motivation for such activities is a monetary one, and so that would make no sense whatsoever. But aside from the obvious woes of Flying Officer, which I really do feel terrible for him, even though he does appear to be getting his games back, I doubt anything can or will be done in regards to microtransactions or achievements. I'm also extremely concerned about the apparent lack of safety measures that EA has in place. To show you what I'm talking about, I'm going to draw on my own standards that we use at my day job, which is an IT consulting firm. It's not necessarily a direct apples-to-apples comparison, but it'll give you at least a baseline idea of where my mindset is coming from here. Now, let's say that we have a client that needs to disable a user's account for some reason or another. Maybe they're retiring, or they quit, or they got fired for some reason. We first require that in writing from a stakeholder or someone identified as a staff member with the authority to make those kinds of decisions. We then verify the decision with them, and then we proceed to disable the account, not delete it. It then goes into a bin specifically created for that purpose, along with the notes on the account with the date it was disabled, and we include the ticket number for internal tracking. We then verify the account deletion over the phone, and we also send a follow-up email as well, because double tap, and then the account remains disabled but still present for a period of 30 days, at which point it is then removed. Of course, even then, there are ways to get it back because we make sure to enable Active Directory Recycle Bin for all the companies that we manage, and then worst comes to worst, there are tombstones after that. But that's all tech speak that we don't really need to go into. Suffice to say, for the first 30 days, if there was some form of mistake made, it's 30 seconds and that account is active and usable again. And all of that is just for a staff member of a company that we manage at my day job. Are all of those extra precautions necessary in that scenario? No, of course not. It's clearly overkill and better than 99% of the time completely unnecessary. But what about in the case of Flying Officer? What about in the case of any account on a digital distribution platform? Remember, this is your money that you paid this platform in good faith for digital goods. And when you are dealing with video games that equate to hundreds and thousands of dollars worth of software, you should absolutely expect there to be painstaking precautions like those I listed above as a bare minimum to protect you and your ability to access that software that you spent so much money on over the course of months and years. Could he have secured his account better? Well, we have no way of determining that. For all we know, he could have had done everything right with his account. Again, it's somewhat doubtful that this issue was due to an account being compromised due to the fact that, again, in most cases, that driving force behind such actions are monetary in nature. A hacker wouldn't delete an account, they would sell it. The fact is, this is a huge mistake on EA's part, and their lackluster response in this scenario is completely disgusting. This should have been alarms going off all over the place, senior technicians and management getting involved here, because with a situation like this, it isn't even necessarily about that one account anymore. This is about all of the accounts that they manage. He's been battling this for 2 weeks already, and the account just vanished. No one at EA was able to find anything? That tells me that Electronic Arts either has no policies or procedures in place in order to prevent accidental permanent account deletions, or the policies that they do have are completely inadequate and unacceptable. This is your money and your property that they're basically shrugging off here. And what would have happened to Flying Officer had this story not picked up traction on Reddit and caught the eye of community managers there? He would have been completely screwed. It also makes me wonder, how many times has this happened that we aren't aware of? I doubt it's a widespread issue. I think if it were, at least one or more of those stories would have raised enough noise for us to be aware of, but this even happening once is still completely inexcusable. They don't have a ticketing system in place to track account deletions? Does it honestly happen often enough that it would get lost in the shuffle? Somehow, I highly doubt that. You see, for even as large a company as EA, when you purchase something on a digital distribution platform like Origin, do you really think it common that someone would actually delete the account and just say, no, I don't want this software that I paid for anymore? I honestly can't imagine a scenario where that would be the case. It's a bit scary, though, to think that the hundreds of dollars I've spent could just disappear like that. Not because of a platform shutting down or an account being stolen, but that it could potentially just vanish without a trace and that platform just shrug their shoulders and say that they have no record of that account existing. You're shit out of luck. Have a nice day. Please log into the account that we're telling you doesn't exist and never existed and fill out this form to let us know how you felt about our service today. I know I try to avoid cursing overly much in my videos, but EA, you seriously need to get your shit together and make sure that something like this never happens again. I don't think I need to remind you twice that with a situation like this, visibility is key, so please do like and share this video as much as possible. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and I'll see you next time.